Hello everyone, let's take a look at question number 36. Question number 36 says that in a Young's double slit experiment, slits are separated by 0.2 millimeter and the screen is placed 120 centimeter away. A beam of light consisting of two wavelengths, 720 nanometer and 480 nanometer, is used to obtain interference fringes on the screen. The least distance at which the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths will coincide is the distance that has been asked of us, and the options that are given to us are 9.75 millimeter, 15.6 millimeter, 3.56 millimeter, and 8.64 millimeter. And the answer to this question comes out to be 8.64 millimeter. Let's quickly take a look at how we get this answer. The first thing to remember is that this sum is very, very simple. However, it is tricky to understand what is being asked of us. So to do that, let's recall what happens in a Young's double slit experiment. I'm not going to say everything, but I'm quickly going to revise what you already know. In Young's double slit experiment, you take a narrow single slit and light is emergent on this narrow single slit, and the light which passes through this narrow single slit, which we call as S, is then incident on two parallel narrow slits which are separated by some distance d, and then these two parallel narrow slits, which are S1 and S2, act as what are known as coherent sources, and then these two sets of waves, one coming from S1 and the other coming from S2, are what interfere with each other to give you what is known as an interference pattern on the screen. And what is an interference pattern? It is nothing but regions of variation of intensity. And therefore, this is the Young's double slit experiment. However, in Young's double slit experiment, the light which is coming in is monochromatic light. But in our sum, we have been told that there are two sets of wavelengths, that is 720 nanometer and 480 nanometer. And therefore, right off the bat, let me make you understand what does it mean when I say there are two sets of wavelength. It basically means that you will have this experiment with 720 nanometer, you will get its interference pattern. Then you will have this experiment with 480 nanometer and you will get its interference pattern. And when you superimpose these interference patterns on top of each other, then they're asking you that when will the bright fringe due to one coincide with the bright fringe due to two? And instead of doing that, what you can do is immediately from the beginning, give what are known as both the wavelengths together. So we have been given Young's double slit experiment. Of course, you know that when the crests of one set of waves fall on the crests of the other set of waves, we get what are known as regions of bright intensity, and these are your maximum brightness points. Similarly, when you have troughs of one set of waves falling on troughs of the other set of waves, those are also maximum brightness region. But when the crest of one set of waves falls on the trough of the other set of waves, those are known as your dark regions, that is regions of low intensity. So interference pattern has bright and dark regions. What else have we been told in this sum? We have been told that the distance between the slits is 0.2 millimeter. That is something we denote by small d. We have also been told that the screen is 120 centimeter away, that is capital D. Finally, we have also been told that the incoming light has two wavelengths, 720 nanometer and 480 nanometer. To understand this sum, like I said, think that if you use each of these monochromatic lights separately, you get two interference patterns. Think about what is being asked. We are being asked, when will the bright fringe due to one coincide with the bright fringe due to the other? That's exactly what is happening, except we are putting both the two lights together. So now let's solve the sum. We have been told what is small d, capital D, and the two wavelengths. I'm going to need all of this, so I'm going to save it on top on the right. So this is my input or the given data. Now I solve the sum, and to do that, I'm going to ask what has been told to me. Well, we have been told in the sum that what we need to find is the least distance at which the bright fringe due to both the wavelengths will coincide. Now let me assume that the distance at which the bright fringe due to both of them coincide is some distance y from the central maxima. Central maxima is our reference point, and I'm saying that at some distance y from the central maxima, the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths coincide. And because they coincide, of course, the distance will be y, which will be the same for both the wavelengths. Now, let me say that the bright fringe of one is coinciding with the bright fringe of the other. Now, it is not necessary that the same order of the fringe for lambda 1 will coincide with the same order of the fringe for lambda 2. So, I'm going to take two separate letters to denote the order of the fringe for lambda 1 and lambda 2. I'm going to say that the order of the fringe for lambda 1 is n1 and the order of the fringe for lambda 2 is n2, and therefore I say that the n1th order for lambda 1 is going to match the n2th order for lambda 2. So I have written n1th bright fringe of lambda 1 is equal to the n2th bright fringe of lambda 2. Okay, that means which order of lambda 1 is coinciding with which order of lambda 2? n1 order of lambda 1 coincides with n2 order of lambda 2. But the general formula for finding the distance of a bright fringe from the central maxima is given to us from the formula y is equal to m lambda capital D by D, where m is nothing but the order of the fringe, lambda is nothing but the wavelength, capital D is nothing but the distance between the slits and the screen, and small d is the distance between the slits. Now I can write this formula for the wavelength lambda 1 and I can write it for the wavelength lambda 2. So let's quickly write it. If I write it for wavelength lambda 1, then I will write y1 is equal to n1, because n1 is the order I'm considering, lambda 1, which is the wavelength, capital D upon D. And if I write it for lambda 2, then I write y2 is equal to n2 lambda 2, capital D upon D. But the whole point of this question is that I'm asking, when do these coincide? And if they coincide, it means their distances must be same, and therefore y1 must be equal to y2. And therefore I will write n1 lambda 1 capital D upon small d is equal to n2 lambda 2 capital D upon small d. And now if I solve or rearrange this expression, I get n1 upon n2 is equal to lambda 2 upon lambda 1. But lambda 2 is given to me as 480 nanometer and lambda 1 is given to be as 720 nanometer, and this comes out to be 2 by 3. Now what have I achieved by finding out what is n1 upon n2? I got n1 upon n2 is equal to 2 by 3. But this is the least integral equation that I can find. What do I mean by that? If n1 upon n2 is equal to 2 by 3, it can also be equal to 4 by 6. It can also be equal to 8 by 12, but I'm not counting any of those. I'm counting it as 2 by 3 because what we have been asked is the least distance at which the bright fringes coincide. So I'm going to reduce it to the lowest integral fraction that I can find, and the lowest one is 2 by 3. Once I get n1 upon n2 is equal to 2 by 3, it is only a matter of interpretation. Now see what's happening. n1 upon n2 is equal to 2 by 3. This means that n1 is equal to 2 and n2 is equal to 3. Like I said, they could be multiples of these numbers. However, since their ratio is the same, we can take it as 2 upon 3. And since we need the least distance, we take the smallest integral fraction. And therefore, I say n1 is 2 and n2 is 3. Which means I already know now that n1 is 2. Once I know n1 is 2, I can directly find y, which is nothing but n1 lambda 1 capital D upon D. n1 I just found is 2. Lambda 1 is nothing but the wavelength 720. Nanometers converted to meters is into 10 raised to minus 9. Capital D is 120 centimeters, which when converted to meter is 1.2, divided by small d, which is 0.2 millimeter or 0.2 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. And this gives me the final answer, that is the distance at which the bright fringes coincide is 8.64 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter or 8.64 millimeter. I hope you have understood this sum. Thank you for watching.